this session, I would like to give you an explanation about tenses, okay, of both class 4 and 5 from your English grammar book, okay. So, let's begin with the chapter simple tenses, okay. So, tense, that means car, okay, tense means car. It is the time period, okay, the time period when the verb will happen, when the verb is happening and when the verb had happened, okay. That means the action which is taking place in present is known as present tense. Action which have taken place at the past is known as past tense. And the action which will take place in future is known as future tense. So there are three types of tenses. Tense means what? Car. It is the time period. Tense means car. It is the time period. There are three types of tenses. Simple present tense, simple past tense and simple future tense. Right? Three types of tenses. Simple present tense, simple past tense and simple future tense. Let's define what is simple present tense. Simple present tense, the things that are happening now in the present time, it is known as simple present tense. We use the present tense in this verb. Okay, so in the present tense, we show the action which is happening in the present time, which is happening now. Okay, so this is known as simple present tense. Simple past tense, things that had happened before now, and we use the past tense there. That means the action which had happened sometimes ago in past times. Okay, so it is known as simple past tense. Simple future tense. The things that will happen later, we use the future tense. That means the things which will happen somewhat in future times. The action will take place sometime from now in the future times. It is known as simple future tense. We will get to know by some example. The gardener waters the plant. That means the gardener every day waters the plant, which is present tense. My father goes to office by car. Regularly my father is going to the office by car, which shows the simple present tense. The highlighted word shows the simple present tense used in the sentence. Second one, simple past tense. The gardener watered the plant. Watered is the past tense used here to show that the gardener had watered the plant somewhat in past tense. Okay? We reached the airport at the time. What happened? We reached the airport at the time in past time. So here the reach is the past tense used in the sentence to show the past time. Simple future tense, the gardener will water the plant. That means the gardener will water the plant somewhat in future time. It will be hot this summer, which is a explanation of a time which will come in the near future, that the summer will be hot. So these two sentences and the highlighted words shows the future tense used in the particular sentence. I would like to explain you in the more detailed part in this one. Okay, let's see. Now I will explain you where simple present tense is used. Okay, simple present tense is used to express number one, point number one, minded, regular or habitual actions. The action which are regular in sense, which are in habit, in practice. Okay, example I will be showing. I go for a walk every day. That means every day I go for a morning walk. You swim every day. You swim every day, which is a continuous process and you are doing every day. Okay, actually we are doing every day. It is a regular habit. So the present tense is used to show the regular or habitual actions. Second one, universal truth. Present tense is used to show universal truth which cannot be denied. Okay, universal truth. For example, the earth revolves around the sun. It is a universal truth that the earth is revolving around the sun. We all know that. The sun rises in the east. Every day we know that the sun is rising in the east, which is a universal truth. Present tense is used to show the universal truth. Third statement. Statements that are always true. Present tense is used to show the statements that are always true in nature. For example, horse has neat, duck quacks, which are true in nature, which everyone knows. Okay? Events, action and situation without any time reference can be expressed as present tense. Present tense can be used to express event, action and situation without any time differences. For example, my uncle lives in Chennai, which is a present tense. That means my uncle is living in Chennai right now also. So it is a present tense. Gia reads book. Gia likes to read book and she is always reading books. So it is a present tense. Now, Future events can also be expressed according to the present tense. Father leaves for Kolkata next Monday. Generally, when we talk, we express the things in present tense for the future events also. Father leaves for Kolkata next Monday. That means my father is going to leave for the Kolkata the next Monday. The annual examination begins on the 7th March. 7th March is the date when annual examination will begin. So, the future events can also be expressed in terms of simple present tense. Now, we would like to explain the simple past tense and simple future tense respectively, where they are used and how they express themselves. Okay? Now, I will explain you where to use simple past tenses. Simple past tense is used to express action or events completed in the past. So, simple past tense is used in the sentence to express the action of the events which is completed or taken place in the past time. For example, I wrote a letter to my friend last night. That means I have already written a letter. I had already written a letter in the past time, which is last night, and which is giving a sense of past time. Okay, so it is a sentence which shows the action which has already taken place in the past time. Second one is Mr. Bahar paid the bill yesterday. When did Mr. Bahar paid the bill? Mr. Bahar had paid the bill yesterday. Okay, so that is the action or the event taking place in the past time. Past habits. Simple past tense is used in the sentences to show past habits. For example, Ganesha played basketball when she was young. Ganesha used to play basketball when she was young. Now she has grown up child. She had left this habit of playing the basketball. Okay? Grandfather went to the temple regularly. Earlier what happened? Grandfather was going to the temple regularly, but now the things had changed. Events that happened a long time ago, past tense is used to show events that have happened a long time ago. For example, India achieved independence in 1947. When did India achieve independence? That is in the past time, which is 1947. Alexander Graham Bell invented the telephone. So what happened? This sentence shows that Alexander Graham Bell had invented the telephone in 1976, which is the past time. Okay? So these all things and events are shown in simple past tense in the sentences. Okay? Now, action that were completely recently, that means past tense is also used in sentences which have completed recently. For example, Tia left Amir Bank. What happened? Tia had just now completed the work and she had left. Mamta had just called 2 minutes back. Okay, so these two sentences expresses that the action has completed recently and can be written in the past tense. Simple future tense, it is used to express action that will be happening in the future time. Future tenses expresses the action which will take place in future time. For example, you will receive the book by post. The book you will be receiving by post will come in the future time, and this sentence shows the future tense in this particular sentence. We shall fly to London next week. That means we are planning to fly to London next week, which shows the shall fly, will receive. These two highlighted words show the future tense used in this particular sentence. Now, predict the events that will happen in the future. Future tense is used in the sentence to predict the events that will happen in the future. For the example that it will rain tonight, that means it is a chance to rain in tonight. And will rain is the highlighted word which shows that things will happen in the near future. Second one, Rashi will top in the class. She is doing a hard work and she will top in the class, which is a sense in the future time. So these two sentences show that things will happen in the future time. So I hope that you have understood this chapter, and the three tenses, the present, past and future, are quite now you are able to understand. Okay? So in the next session I will be explaining the next chapter very carefully, and thank you and have a nice day.